Our regularly scheduled programming will not be seen this morning, so that we may bring to you the 2021 holiday special.
How's it going, my friends? My name is Astro, and welcome to the 2021 Christmas special. Now, here we are on Minecraft, as promised in the last video. We're actually on a temporary world because I am in the process of testing shaders on 1.18 for Stream Hell. So yeah, temporary map, we'll be back to normal next year. Let's just get right into this. So, just a little show off of this map before we really get into things. Take a look at these houses. It's pretty neat. Oh, what's this? House design from Pixel Riffs on YouTube. Alright. So, yeah. You got your kitchen here. You got your fireplace. Nice touch with the scaffolding as a table. Here's your bedroom here. Got some nice bunk beds. And then upstairs, there isn't really anything, but take a look outside. This is lovely. Imagine just living here. That's something I would want to do. There's not much of interest in that building. Actually, I don't think there's anything in that building. Yeah, no. And then down there, all the stuff over there, I will leave to you guys, because I will leave the link to this world in the description down below. But anyway, that's not where we're staying. Over here is where we're staying. Down on Diamond Road, you get a look at this. And holy shit, is this beautiful. Yeah, imagine staying here. Like you take your family out for a little holiday vacation, you bring them out here. This is just beautiful. And would you look at that? There's presents under the tree. Ain't that lovely? Yeah. It's nice. Get little Apple laptops. It's a nice little touch. But yeah, enough of the map. We're just here to take part in a holiday tradition for me, which is reading the stories of idiots on the internet. Yeah, we're becoming a green text reading channel. Sorry! But yeah, anyway. Without further ado, here are a few Christmas-themed tales from around 4chan. So, grab a loved one, grab a drink, grab a snack, grab a seat, grab anything, because the 2021 holiday special starts now. Christmas Day. Everyone handing out gifts. Get a really cringy t-shirt that says, "If you see me outside, don't mess with me, I've been gaming." Aunt says, "Oh, that fits you so well, Anon! Always in your cave playing those games!" Meek out some pathetic laughter and say, "Thanks." Next gift I get is actually Nvidia. But I don't own the console, it's for... Hey, I appreciate it, but I don't have a...
Anon, you're always like this! Unappreciative and self-centered! Maybe if you stopped being a hermit every once in a while, you'd actually know how to talk to someone!
After everyone gets through with gifts, go back to my bed and cry myself to sleep. So, Anons, how was your Christmas?
Be me, working at GameStop. Parent asks for a game called COD. Tell her there is no game called COD, but her son probably meant Rapala Pro Bass Fishing. There are lots of fish in that game, and the closest we have a ton of copies in the back. We have a deal on. If you buy two copies, you get one free. She buys three brand new copies of this game. She comes back after Christmas. All three copies have been opened. No refund because you opened them. A kid out there received three copies of a fucking fishing game for Christmas. Atheism turned me into a little cringe retard when I was a teenager. On Christmas Day, when I was 14, I came downstairs during the night and destroyed the tree and left a note for my family.
I can't remember exactly, but the note was something like, I have removed the angel from the tree and replaced it with a Bunsen burner, the real bringer of light. I have removed chocolate from the tree. Science doesn't allow chocolate to grow on trees. I have removed the decorations for the same reason. The presents beneath the tree will be burnt if I ever see them placed in the presence of religion again. My dad beat the shit out of me and gave all my presents to my brothers. My parents bought me a fucking bonsai tree. I didn't ask for this responsibility, I have no idea how to look after it, and I keep reading about soil feed and shit. Can I just water it? No. Overwatering and underwatering is fatal, lol. Seriously, fuck this shit. I didn't need this on Christmas. This pressure. I asked them why they bought me it, and apparently, you went to Japan for 2 months 3 years ago, is a good enough reason to entrust a fucking life on me. I can't do it. I already feel the pressure, and I'm physically shaking and feel unwell. I used to have a pet hamster, and I killed it because I thought it might eat a cricket, and the cricket ripped its eyes out, and they expect me to care for a sensitive, awful tree? I literally went downstairs 3 minutes ago to try and protest without seeming insensitive. Here's how it went. Hey, this bonsai is lovely, but I'm worried about maintaining the correct humidity in my room.
Oh, don't worry, son! Your room is so sticky from video game sweat that I'm sure the tree will grow!
Yeah, but I also worry that it might end up being overwatered.
Oh no, of course not! You went to Japan, you know how to water a bonsai tree!
I'm not sure though, I don't want to hurt the tree. It is beautiful and I want it to thrive.
I know! You love it! We are good, aren't we?
Yeah, thanks. I'll go water it.
Just don't give it too much! It might think there's another tsunami!
I am fucked! Is there any way to euthanize a bonsai tree? I don't want it to suffer. I already swung in it with a meat cleaver but missed. Be neat. Family is over for Christmas. I have an uncle who is super conservative and religious to the point where it's hilarious. He's really into ancestry and DNA shit. Aunt brought up she saw a documentary about tracing back Jesus' ancestry or something. Aunt pulls up on her phone a picture of what they think Jesus would have looked like. Uncle makes a comment about how he doesn't look feminized like the media makes him out to be, and how he looks masculine in the picture. Start laughing. Try to stop, but I can't. After a second, I manage to stop by drinking water. Fuck, I messed up, bros. Be last year. Be 19. Family gets invited to my uncle's yearly Christmas dinner. I'd much rather play on my $3,500 PC my parents got me for Christmas. Had PC for a total of 6 hours. We're all sitting around the table. I have to sit beside my uncle's faggot 8-year-old kid. I bet he doesn't even play on PC like me, a true gamer. There may be hope, however. As the adults are talking, 8-year-old strikes up a conversation with me.
Do you play video games, Anon?
I scoff. Do I play video games? I laugh a hearty, phlegmy laugh. This plebe has the gall to ask me that. Proceed to proudly tell him all about my PC that I obtained earlier in the day.
That's cool,
he replies. He should be sucking the dick of a master race member like me. I let it go because he's only 8. He responds,
my parents got me an Xbox One for my birthday in the summer.
I start sweating. My cousin is a console peasant?
I like playing Advanced Warfare on it. It's really fun.
My eye twitches. My neck beard itches. My 8-year-old cousin is a casual. Finally lose it. Stand up quickly. Kick his chair down. At this point, people around the table are shocked. Yell at him for denying the master race. Waddle over to the Xbox One in the living room. Smash it. Throw it out of the window. Grab copy of Advanced Warfare. Take disc out. Grab kitchen scissors. Cut the filthy game in half.
cousin is bawling his eyes out. Serves the little fucker right. Everyone else too shocked and confused to do anything. I step on the disc remains. Parents stand up and drag me out of the house.
You can't deny the master race!
I yell. My face went not invited back again this year. Like I would want to dine with those faggot casuals again. Try to kill myself. Guardian Angel saves me. He shows me what my life would be like if I were never born. Turns out, everything is better, and everyone is happier. Guardian Angel kills himself. Wow, that would make a very nice movie.
Was the night before Kwanzaa, and all through the slum. Not a creature was stirring, not even a bum. The children had braided their cornrows with care, in the hope that St. Malcolm would soon be there. The Crips and the Bloods made their holiday peace. The protesters protested. Fuck the police. The Jews and Koreans hid under their beds, while visions of rioters danced in their heads. And Marcus with his do-rag, and I in my cap, had just settled down for a long session of rap. When out from the lawn, there arose a clatter. Two beaners running, trying to steal my ladder. Not on my block, I exclaimed with a smile, for slaying these wetbacks would sure take a while. Torture them I did, with a long sly grin. Now give me the location of your next of kin. Loud were the screams of anguish that night, as we crusaded to exterminate this Mexican blight. Women, children, little babies too, all without question from the boys in blue. For this Christmas miracle could be enjoyed by all, not a single dirty Mexican blowing leaves this fall. And after cleansing beaner blood from my shirt, I could finally sit down and enjoy my work. Merry Christmas, Happy Kwanzaa, and blame it on the Jews.
3 days before Christmas. Grandparents arrive, we all go out for dinner. Merry time had by all. 2 days before Christmas. Sister and I go out shopping for some last-minute gifts for little brother. She teases me about not having a girlfriend for the holidays at the food court. Bump into some mutual friends of ours, good time had by all. 'Twas the night before Christmas. Parents off work, I'm off work. Little brother challenges me to some Street Fighter 4 and such. Sister remains addicted to Cut the Rope. That night, we all go out in the minivan to look at Christmas lights in the area. Merriment had by all. Christmas. Little brother plays elf and passes out gifts. Everyone tears into gifts, showing off what we all got. Got my mom a pendant she'd handed for, dad a new speaker system for his midlife crisis car, as we call it. Got little bro a small stack of 360 games and my sis an iTunes card, and a couple 3DS games she wanted. Had to ask the folks what the grandparents wanted, so I got them one of those Keurig coffee machines. Unwrapping is all done.
Anon, why didn't you unwrap your gifts?
Looks around. What gifts, Mom? Conversation and merriment stops like a train wreck.
Anon, what do you mean, what gifts?
Look around, puzzled, wondering if this is the beginning of a gag or... Turns to Dad. Honey, you did remember to buy Anon his gifts, right?
What do you mean, me? You were supposed to shop for Anon this year!
Slowly dawning horror. Little Anon, what happened to the money we gave you to buy something for your brother?
I got myself a skateboard! Wanna see it?
Anon, sis?
Mother, I told you I ran out of money. You were supposed to cover for me until I repaid you back, remember?
Turns to grandparents.
Grandma went to the bank to get some cash to put in an envelope for him.
No, dear. That's what you were going to do when you went to the store the other day for more stuffing.
It was?
Holy shit. I was forgotten? Parents start arguing. Little bro laughing about how Santa forgot about me. Sis won't even look in my direction, though her face is beet red. Sit there, stunned, for several minutes, listening to my parents and grandparents argue back and forth in between them, mother alternating to scream at little bro while he keeps laughing. Sis just pulls her knees up and continues to pretend to ignore me. She keeps looking at me in a way really fast. Eventually, just leave the room so I don't have to listen to all this.
go to room and start reading a book I'd been meaning to start, Lord of the Rings, if you must know. Anything to drown out the shouting and my own heartbroken thoughts. Eventually, the noise drowns out. Leave my room in hopes that it's some really bad gag. Enter the living room. Conversation sputters when they see me, then hesitantly and awkwardly starts back up again. Look at Sis again. I've always been close to Sis, even if she's a bit of a spoiled brat as the only girl. She still refuses to hold eye contact, but she looks about as miserable as I feel. Go to kitchen, get some water, go back to my book. Mother pops her head in after a few hours.
Anon, why didn't you come out and socialize with us?
Kinda hard to do that when the conversation stops the second I walk into the room. Argument commences. Argument stops when I finally ask, how did you guys just forget me? Mom states that we'll go out tomorrow to find something I want. Kinda not the point here, Mom. Mom gets all shame-faced and walks away. Give them a few more minutes before I leave my room as well. Conversation turns awkward when I enter the room again. Stays awkward when they see me take a seat on the couch. Everyone turns away in turn when I look at them. Even little bro isn't teasing me anymore. Whatever Mom shouted at him must have stuck. Rest of the day awkward. Dinner awkward. Go to bed. Not one single person said sorry. Not one single person spoke to me unless I spoke up in conversation first. Not one single person responded to direct attempts to make conversation with more than 5 syllables. Dick around on 4chan for a bit before falling asleep. Have weird-ass dreams, such as one where my father knocked up my best female friend and she gave him syphilis in turn. Day after Christmas. Boxing Day. Grandparents left 3 days early. Bright and early. Parents went to work without saying bye. Sis out with their friends. Little bro out with his friends. No gag. No lie. I was forgotten. Dicking around on 4chan because I really don't want to be out and about with my friends right now. Anon, if you're reading this, I hope you're okay. Be me. Sister and I raised by single mom. Sister and I have been in college for a few years now. Emptiness.jpg. Mom's job recently got hit in a round of layoffs. New job barely covers the rent. 1 T years for those fuckers and let go with a day's notice. But I digress. We're away from home, but we see her struggling. Me and my sister hatch a plan for Christmas. We save up money between us and some friends. The day comes. Mom wakes up to a deposit of $1,500 from both me and my sister. She starts to cry. Sister starts to cry. I start to cry. I love you, Mom. Aw, that's nice. Be me. Yesterday. Christmas time is coming at gmail.com. My mom still asks me for my list even though I'm 18 and going to a good uni. Make a hefty list knowing she can't get everything. Snoop around a bit. Go on Amazon. What? My mom literally bought nearly everything. Literally, almost everything. Cry a little, realizing how fucking lucky I am and understand why she gets stressed around the holidays. My face when I have one of the best moms out there. My face when I will graduate and become a history professor for my mom one day. My face when, though life can suck my fucking ass, my mom makes it a bit better. Lads, I know this is 4chan, but seriously, go hug your mom or call her on the holidays. It's worth it. And oh my god, what a good story to end out on. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, I just want to thank you guys for tuning in tonight. Just thanks for sticking with me throughout the year and all that fun stuff. Before I go tonight, though, I just want to, give you a little blooper reel of all the times I fucked up getting the readings out. But aside from that, yeah. I'll see you guys back here in just a moment. Enjoy the reel.
'Twas the night before Kwanzaa, and all through the children had braided their cornrows with care in the while visions of rioters danced in their heads.
from the lawn. There arose a... Fuck! This plebe has the gall to ask me that. Proceed to proudly tell him about all my PC that... Fuck. What happened to the money we gave you to buy something for your brother?
I got myself a game book.
Fuck! You know, even after the 6 years that we've had on this channel, I didn't think I'd actually ever get to the point where I'd be pushing out high quality content that I have fun doing. So now, as we close out the year in uploading for me, I just want to give one big final thank you to all those that have been supporting me. I want to give a thank you to everyone who's tuned in, gotten my channel out there. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching. I will return next year. You guys know what to do. And to you, my 117 subscribers, thank you so much for joining me today. Merry Christmas. If you're traveling with family, get home safe. If you're staying at home, happy holidays. So, that being said, I am Astro, and I am saying so long for now. I will see you next year. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and good night, everyone.